Hello.
Is it okay to record?
Yes, it is.
Okay, great.
Right this way.
Thank you.
Volume coverage pattern, which means it's able to get the data to us faster. And the precipitation on the radar, we can make it spin faster, basically. And that
here is our communications area. The person sitting here takes calls from spotters that call in, severe weather, tornadoes. They keep an eye on Twitter, Facebook. This is a unique little system here. It lets you watch several different mass media feeds in one instrument, like Facebook and Twitter both be in the same one. It's called Hootsuite. This one is TweetDeck, which it doesn't have. We get more and more monitoring our reports via the internet, Facebook, et cetera, especially Twitter. I think we got, was it 20,000 likes or something? What do we have?
We're past that. We're probably above 35,000.
We're at 35. Yeah. And I worked, like I said, I worked in Hurricane Sandy in New York City. They don't have that many followers. Most of the forecast offices around us don't. I don't know why it's such a phenomenon here, but it is. And it's growing every day. We have a person here, especially during severe weather, just to monitor this and answer the phones and take reports. And the other stations are, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sets of stations. You can see the guys working at, and they're putting together forecasts. That's also where we do warnings. And the big screen up above Kevin there, that's where we give briefings and kind of have a situational awareness of what's going on. Like we were working severe weather, we'd throw up probably multiple radars up there to watch, where everybody in the room could look up and see it, not just the warning forecasters. Let's see. And over here on the left, you see 3 radar screens. We're one of the few offices that actually has control of 3 radars, one just north of Evansville, Indiana, one right out back here, and then one at Fort Campbell, Department of Defense radar. It's all controlled by these 3 little machines behind these people here. On the right, 3 screens. We have the current forecast. The middle is a monitor to monitor products, equipment, and it'll change red and let us know if things are going bad or wrong or hiccups. Storm prediction center is the top right one. You know, slight risk, moderate risk. We just keep that up so we can monitor it. The bottom center on both sides are security cameras so we can see what's going on outside the building at all times. We're 24/7 here, so usually at least 2 people here all the time and never close. Yeah. Big screen.
Radar set of observations, weather observations, all that information goes into here is where we got a lot more moisture in the atmosphere. And this one is actually what the computer models think where precipitation is going to fall on. This model it actually comes from Europe. But we've got several models that come from the United States, some of them that are so high resolution that it can go down to storm scale.
What he's showing right there, it actually says in the future this is where it's going to be raining and how much it's going to be raining. When you hear us refer to models, that's what we're talking about, things of that nature. And we look at a whole suite of these models. And one thing we can almost always be sure of, the model is going to be wrong. And we have to take the strengths and weaknesses of those models from experience and use that to hopefully create a better, more accurate forecast. Versus using, like we know one model is known to be too wet. Another model is usually known to be too strong with lift and instability. So we kind of cushion that a little bit. There's no exact amount of how much any model's off at any given time unless you're measuring it against something. But he was going out like 10 days on that map. He was losing, showing you the moisture.
Yeah, that's right here.
Oh, there you go. This is our graphical forecast editor they talked about. That's 58 counties spread across Kentucky, Indiana, Illinois, and Missouri. And that red right there is where he has rain in the forecast, thunderstorms. Each hour he's got it differently. That's green is just showers. And each one of those things over on the left is a different parameter, like clouds, temperature, wind speed, wind gusts. And he edits each one of those into what he thinks it will be. When he gets done, he'll say, now generate my forecast. And he'll put into English words those pictures. He'll take it and put it into words. Like for today, let's say, annoying siren go off. I'm sure on that little gadget over there, but it's usually when Smitty there pushes the button, makes it go off. And that is run with a synthesized voice. Computerized, it's not a real human voice, but if some reason it was to go down or have a hiccup, Smitty there would go on with those headphones on and go live and start broadcasting live. And that's the way we used to do it a long time ago anyway. But now when he hits that button and those forecasts are generated, it actually goes over to that radio and it starts saying what it turns out. Yes, sir.
Why do you think
TVs in 21? We monitor those. There's stations up there.
It's kind of like medicine. There's no, everybody's different, and you, like one medicine might work for you that doesn't work for me. So to say that they're ever going to get all the glitches out, probably not in my lifetime. But
yeah, they are improving dramatically from what I entered in '89. It's a different place now.
pretty awesome. Said do not touch balloon.